Hi, friends, and welcome to the Jackrabbit Insider. I'm Tyler Merriam. It's great to have you with us for this special edition of the Insider, as this week we look at the rug burners, the clock eaters, the men who ate up enough real estate to earn a spot as one of the best running backs in SDSU history. So pull up a chair. Here are the top 10 rushers ever at South Dakota State. Number 10, Paul Klinger, 2,161 yards. He's the only man to make our list without a 1,000-yard season, doing it with persistence and grit. Overcoming a number of injuries, he led the Jacks in rushing three times over a four-year span.
Paul was a quiet guy. I was fortunate enough to recruit Paul because that was my area at the time, and I really didn't think we were going to get him. I thought we were going to lose him to one of our competitors. But I'll tell you what, when he decided on South Dakota State and he was your perfect tailback, I was excited. And Paul had some injuries when he was here, but again, one of those guys that lined up, didn't say boo, but when the ball was snapped, he was a great football player.
Paul Klinger was one of those guys that I think we'd have to consider a big back. He was, I think, 210 pounds his senior year, which at that time was a really big back. And even though he had the size, he could make you miss both by juking you or by running over you. He had the added dimension of being real good out of the backfield. So we could throw to him and he could make something. Usually it's a one-on-one situation when you get, you know, a swing pass or something, and he was able to beat people.
Paul was, another one of the guys that got the start for us at running back when we're concentrating on running the football, and he was good enough to turn it into a good career for himself.
One of those guys that if he could have stayed healthy for 4 years, played 4 years straight through, he would have been in definitely in that All-American range, but he could flat out play.
Number 9, Rick Weger, 2,293 yards. At only 5'7" and 167 pounds, it would have been easy to overlook the Sioux City, Iowa native, but he could squat and deadlift over 500 pounds and run a 4.4 40. He rushed for 1,317 yards and 11 touchdowns in 1984 to earn All-America honors, highlighted by his career finale, a 39-carry, 231-yard afternoon at Wyoming.
I think he had that chip on his shoulder that because he was a little bit smaller, he had a little bit more to prove, and man, quick, and I think the advantage he had of being small was he hid behind the lineman, and then when he got through, it was too late.
Rick the Quick is what Norm Hilson called him, and very aptly named, probably one of the first running backs that made a real impact that we saw at SDSU, coming out of Sioux City. Kind of a small guy and one of those real quick to the hole, explosive type of runners, and he made his own gains after that, but excellent running back.
Number 8, Darwin Gonnerman, 2,598 yards. The first man to lead the Jacks in rushing three straight seasons, Gonnerman twice passed the 1,000-yard mark in a year. In fact, he ran for exactly 1,023 yards in both 1967 and 68. A two-time All-American, he was voted South Dakota College Player of the Decade for the 1960s.
He was hard to bring down. They couldn't bring him down. And he didn't look fast. I tell you, he and Josh Ronick, you know, neither one of them were fast. But if either one of them got out ahead of everybody, nobody ever caught him. He didn't look fast, but once he got out there, they couldn't catch him. And that's the way Gonnerman was. And that, you know, it's hard to explain, but I guess you don't need to look fast to be fast.
We've already covered the 60s, 80s, and 90s. Up next, we'll hit the 70s and enter the 2000s as our list of the greatest rushers in South Dakota State history continues. But first, won't you come along for a trip inside state?
My favorite piece of apparel that I own, I have a vintage long sleeve jackrabbit, like the old running jackrabbit type shirt.
My name is Clark Sanders. I am from Plymouth, Minnesota.
My aunt, who's from Rapid, she found it for me and mailed it to me, so I love that one. I'm an advertising major with a marketing minor and a graphic design certificate. I wanted to be across the board, and SDSU offered that for me, so that was amazing. I guess my college search was a little bit different. I initially was looking at doing athletics. I was a volleyball player, so I was getting recruited into some other schools, and so I went and visited there, and just nothing really stood out compared to SDSU. SDSU was the first school that I did ever tour, and the minute I stepped out of the car, I felt at home. And I was like, Mom, I'm going here. And she was like, well, let's check out a couple other ones before you make that choice. So I did the whole North Dakota tour, and then a couple schools in Wisconsin. And I don't know, they just didn't have the finesse that SDSU had. You don't have to know who you are. I feel like a lot of students will come in thinking that they need to know what it is that they want to do. But I think the best advice is that you really don't. We have so many different things on campus to do that you can kind of find out what it is that you like. This place has such a positive atmosphere that you can do anything, go anywhere kind of atmosphere with it. The other day I was driving to work, and on my way to work, they had just hung up the giant jackrabbit on our S-Jack. So I'm coming around there and I drive past there every day, but that was the first time I saw the jackrabbit. And it's like something just hit me that I was so proud to be a jackrabbit.
Stay tuned, more of the Jackrabbit Insider is coming up.
How did we become the region's largest independent seed company? By taking a very simple but powerful stand. We will sell no seed that we wouldn't be happy to plant on our own farm. Peterson Farm Seed. Stand tall.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
This portion of the Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it.
Our special edition of the Jackrabbit Insider continues as we count down the 10 greatest rushers in South Dakota state history. Our next back may be number 7 on our list, but he also has what in my book is the most memorable run in SDSU history. Number 7, Corey Koenig, 2,990 yards. Splitting time throughout his first 3 years, Koenig became the featured back as a senior. He responded with 1,266 rushing yards and 15 touchdowns, helping the Jacks win the Great West Conference Championship, the program's first league title in 44 years. And it was this fourth quarter run against North Dakota State that gave the Jacks the final margin in that championship game.
Corey was a self-made running back. You know, I don't know about his, you know, they talk about a lot of natural skills as a running back. I think Corey came in here and said, I'm not going to mess around. I'm going to be a great student, I'm going to be a great athlete, and I'm going to have success in all those. And on the football field, there was no gray area for Corey. When there was a yard to be got, he got two of them and made some big plays for us, and he's going to be a doctor, a medical doctor. Just a really neat story.
Early in his career, he teamed with Anthony Watson. It was a great running back tandem there. A little bit different running backs, different styles. Corey's was basically straight ahead, and I think that's one of the reasons why he kind of just kept moving up in the program was he'd see that hole and hit it. And you know, we hadn't had a running back like that probably since Josh Ronick in terms of identifying where the hole was and just getting to that hole as quickly as possible and then accelerating from there.
Corey Koenig is one player that I have one play in mind for when I think of him, and it's that fourth down touchdown run against North Dakota State when the Bison came into Coughlin ranked number one. And then if I remember right afterwards, I think he credited that run where he sort of high-kneed his way through a tackle to his hunting prowess, and that he would go out hunting a lot, and that walking in the waders through the water in the muck sort of helped build that move for him.
Corey was one of those guys, just real, real serious about everything that he did. I mean, you wouldn't be able to tell after a game if we had won or lost, just based on his facial expressions, just very focused, determined, very smart individual going into the medical field, and academic All-American, as well as postgraduate scholarship. So just a tremendous, tremendous young man all the way through.
Number six, Les Tuma, 3,018 yards. The Jackrabbit football team only won 16 games in the first 4 years of the 1970s, so it's easy to forget about Les Tuma's contribution. Three times SDSU's leading rusher, he twice eclipsed 1,000 yards in a season and was all North Central Conference during his senior year of 1973.
Les was a grinder. Yeah, he was a tough kid, tough kid. And he had his role and he played it very well.
Number five, Dan Sonic, 3,304 yards. Supersonic ran through the North Central Conference like a tornado during his freshman season and never looked back. The walk-on ran for a Division II best 1,518 yards that rookie year, 993 of that coming in the final five games. Three times All-NCC, Sonic was an All-American in 1987, and he also caught 80 passes for better than 800 yards in his career.
The coaches are having their summer meeting, getting ready to set the roster for fall camp and whatever, and they're sitting in there talking about how we should have maybe offered this kid. And while they're at the meeting, they get a phone call, and Gary Hoffman goes and takes the phone call, and he comes back and he says, "Remember that kid we were just talking about? That was him. He's coming."
One of the slowest running backs you'd ever see, but one of the most effective. I mean, he was, they called him Supersonic.
The kids, I think, lovingly gave him that nickname of Supersonic, and he was tough-nosed. You know, he worked for every yard that he got, and he was fun to watch just because he had strength and size.
Was just a workhorse, and obviously a record holder for several years at SDSU from the running back position, but just a kind of another quiet guy from Minnesota that came on and turned into a great running back.
When he was going forward, he didn't go, if it says, "I got to go to this hole," if there was somebody there, he found out a way to veer around it. You know, he didn't run straight into the pile like some of them do. He just, he got 5 yards out of every play, whether there was anything there or not.
Now we're stepping into real elite company. At least 3,500 yards is required to be in the top four. Find out who's left as we count down the greatest rushers in SDSU history. First, let's take time to remember this Jackrabbit legend.
A skinny kid from Huron who transferred to SDSU for basketball ends up rewriting the football record books. That's the story of this week's Jackrabbit legend, Mike Bush, presented by Legend Seeds. Bush originally attended Idaho State. While he may have been a Tiger in high school, he wasn't destined to be a Bengal. So he returned to his home state and arrived in Brookings on a basketball scholarship. That is, until the football team was short of quarterbacks during spring ball. Bush volunteered, and the rest was literally history. In his first year calling signals, the junior shattered the SDSU's single-season passing mark, throwing for nearly 2,500 yards and 14 touchdowns. The following fall, Bush surpassed his own record, totaling 2,554 yards and 17 touchdowns as a senior. Those seasons are still two of the best ever by an SDSU rifleman. He was selected first-team All-North Central Conference and was the league's most valuable back in 86. But he's best remembered for teaming up with wide receiver Jeff Tiefenthaler to turn the North Central Conference on its head. The tandem connected nearly 100 times for over 2,000 yards and 21 scores by themselves. Bush even earned a cup of coffee in the National Football League, making two starts for the New York Giants during the 1987 strike season. one in front of a national television audience on Monday Night Football. Mike Bush, a Jackrabbit legend. This Jackrabbit legend is presented by Legend Seeds, your regional seed leader.
Listen up. This is the time, this is the place, and this is Ford F-150, the truck that goes toe-to-toe with your life. Made of high-strength, military-grade aluminum alloy, it pulled the highest safety rating the government can give. And with Pro Trailer Backup Assist, it's like having your head on a swivel, pal. So load up your crew. This is the time.
Now get up to $10,395 in total savings or lease an F-150 for just $279 a month. Visit your local Northland Ford dealer today.
Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. For powerful calls. For breakthrough calls. For professional calls. For tough calls. For unexpected calls. For expert calls. Make the right call. Choose the experts. Choose Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine.
Get ready for the Hefties Fan PhD Tip of the Week, encouraging you to get up, get loud, and get involved, and give the Jackrabbits a hometown advantage.
This year was fantastic. I got my best yields ever.
Record yields start by putting the best seed in the ground. At Hefty, we not only pick the best genetics and traits for you, but we have the most stringent seed grower specs in the industry. That means higher yields for you.
We're Hefties! And we're big on the farm.
Hefty brand soybeans. Agronomy answers yield.
Hey, Jax fans. When you hear our school song, Ring the Bell, get on your feet, get involved, sing with it, help make a difference, and really help support our great band.
This week's fan tip was brought to you by Hefty's Fan PhD, helping Jackrabbit fans go from good to great. Before we get back to this week's show, here's a look at next week's Insider. Welcome back to our special edition of the Jackrabbit Insider as we count down the top rushers in South Dakota State history. It's interesting that football is considered to be more of a passing game nowadays, but our next group of running backs all played for current coach John Stiglmeyer after Y2K. Number 4, Anthony Watson, 3,712 yards. He was a constant in the backfield during SDSU's early days of Division I, carrying the ball better than 100 times in each of his four seasons. He eclipsed the 1,000-yard mark in 2004, but ran for better than 900 on two other occasions.
Anthony Watson is a guy that you never knew what was going to happen, both on the field and off the field, but I love Anthony. And he was a young man that came from a situation where a lot of people said in his surroundings he won't make it, and he made it. And he's graduated. He's got his degree. He's a great dad. He was an unbelievable running back. Great moves. Great desire to get yards. But off the field, he was a treat. He was fun to be around.
Interesting kid coming into the program. Coach Stig really worked with him a lot. A very emotional player, a big running back, really seemed to take well to the Jacks, and they, to him, really emotional, wide open kind of guy, talked a lot, fun guy to be around, and a really good football player, and really, it was really good to see him have success.
Sort of underrated. I think when he wrapped up his career and you looked at his numbers, it was like, holy smokes, you know. He did it well over a number of years, maybe at a level that people didn't even sort of appreciate at the time.
Number 3, Kyle Manette, 4,277 yards. Two times All-American and three times All-Missouri Valley Football Conference, Manette played a huge role on SDSU's first Division I playoff squad in 2009. The first Jack to rush for 1,000 yards three straight times, he racked up 54 touchdowns in his first 4 years wearing yellow and blue.
Kyle, literally, and I don't know how this works, but literally, when we needed more out of him, we got more out of him. And it's not like he ever underachieved. It literally, he somehow had another gear or some more energy, and whether it was Stephen F. Austin or Illinois State, it didn't matter. For some reason, Kyle could always make that play when we needed it.
And Kyle certainly didn't disappoint anybody with his play and running with a similar style, I think, to what Ronick had. Not the guy who's got the great breakaway speed, and yet occasionally he could do that on you when you least expected it. And Minette, another one, certainly has to be considered one of the best running backs they've had.
Kind of the mold of Dan Sonic, a little quicker than that, obviously. A lot of yardage, able to make tough plays. Was able to be a real versatile guy, would also block when needed, and just a good all-around kid.
He obviously had a very decorated career, but he meant a lot to this program in a lot of different ways. He was a leader, no question. He was one of the few guys early in that transition that had opportunities maybe to go play at, a North Dakota State or other schools with maybe bigger, at the time, football reputations and chose to come here. He had a savvy, I think, both personally and professionally in terms of his football playing, and just a tough kid, carried a lot of defensive players over the course of his career.
It wasn't a guy who was going to run past people, but he had the ability to run over and through people, and just kind of a grinder and a good receiver, and a very good leader, tremendous mentor to a number of the younger players on the team, and really just had a great perspective about football, about life, about what it meant to be a Jackrabbit.
Number two, Zach Zenner, 6,548 yards. In his first career start as a sophomore, Zenner burst onto the scene when he broke through the line of scrimmage and went 99 yards for a touchdown at Kansas. He led the nation in rushing as a sophomore with 2,044 yards and followed that up with 2,015 yards as a junior and 2,019 more as a senior. That's three 2,000-yard seasons, and he was a three-time consensus All-American. He owns three of the top five single-game rushing performances ever by a Jack, including the school record of 295 yards, which he did twice.
I've said Josh Ronick is the best football player I've ever been around, and that's too bold a statement, but Zach is pushing that. Zach is the same type of guy. He uses every second he's got on and off the field. He's a great leader. His effort raises everybody's left effort, including mine included, because he just draws you to a different level, and a very serious young man.
For as much as he has some of the traits that a lot of the other SDSU greats at running back have had, he's also very much his own guy. Having a conversation with Zenner is unlike having a conversation with anybody else. He just sees the world from a different angle, and I think that's how he's able to be what he is, both as a football player and as a student.
Boy, Zach Zenner was amazing, and opponents agreed, yet despite all of his exploits and all of his accolades, each and every one of them so richly deserved, he's only second on the list. Find out who sits atop Mount Running Back next.
Stay tuned, more of the Jackrabbit Insider is coming up.
Soil is the foundation and the future.
Healthy soil has a lot of organic matter.
Well, a healthy soil has the pore space which allows water to be absorbed.
Good soil is alive. There are more microorganisms in a handful of dirt than there are people on Earth.
We've seen our organic matter increase steadily each year.
As a farmer, I care about the land.
We have to care about the land.
Soil is the foundation of everything.
If we're going to feed a hungry world, we're going to need to have a healthy soil.
Soil health is necessary for our future. I'm Steve Halverson.
Al Miron.
I'm Jeff Lochner.
This is Farming.
The Jackrabbit Insider is brought to you by the Hefty Seed Company, Agronomy, Answers, Yield. Your local Northland Ford dealers. Visit northlandford.com or your local dealer. Sanford Orthopedics and Sports Medicine. Expert care when you need it. The University Bookstore. Shop now at jackrabbitcentral.com. South Dakota corn. This is Farming, proud sponsor of the South Dakota Showdown Series. And by South Dakota State University, be great, start here.
Welcome back. One running back remains on our countdown of the top 10 rushers in Jackrabbit football history. But before we get to the chart topper, let's take one more look back at the list. Number 10, Paul Klinger, 2,161 yards. Number 9, Rick Wieger, 2,293 yards. Number 8, Darwin Gonnerman, 2,598 yards. Number 7, Corey Koenig, 2,990 yards. Number 6, Les Tuma, 3,018 yards. Number 5, Dan Sonic, 3,304 yards. Number 4, Anthony Watson, 3,712 yards. Number 3, Kyle Manette, 4,277 yards.
Number 2, Zach Zenner, 6,548 yards.
And the number one rusher in South Dakota State football history, Josh Ronick, 6,744 yards. The numbers are simply awesome. Three times All-America, 13 200-yard games, 69 career touchdowns. After turning the North Central Conference on its head by running for 1,881 yards as a freshman, a then-school record, he became the first Jack to blitz past 2,000 yards, rushing for 2,055 and 25 touchdowns during his sophomore campaign. Despite a number of injuries, he racked up almost 900 yards as a junior and then added on another 1,804 yards as a senior.
After his career here was done and he went to the CFL, his nickname there was the Little Ball of Hate. And, you know, that's just an accurate description. I wish, you know, we would have come up with that when he played here.
You put the stopwatch on him to time him in the 40. It wasn't bad, but it wasn't all that good. But he's one of those guys who had game speed. If he got one step ahead of you, I don't care how fast you were, you weren't going to catch him.
The greatest thing about Josh was his vision. He would be able to see the field, hit a hole, and just run through it and keep running.
Special guy, great competitor. He can make you miss every way there is to make a person miss.
I claim he's the best football player I've ever been around. As a tailback, he could make the offensive line calls. He understood all that. I mean, he had a mind that, you know, he's a great student also, so it wasn't just football. He had a mind that was so sharp and so dedicated, and his focus was so unbelievable. There were no distractions, no static in Josh Ronick's life.
6,744 rushing yards. Still hard to fathom, but that's how good Josh Ronick was, the greatest rusher in SDSU football history. We hope you enjoyed this special look back, and to rewatch this episode or to find out more on the history of Jackrabbit Athletics, visit our website at gojacks.com. For all of us here in the Yeager Media Center studios, I'm Tyler Merriam, and we'll see you next time on the Jackrabbit Insider.